In this example, we're asked to use logarithmic differentiation in order to find the derivative of f of x equals the quantity 2x minus 3 squared times the quantity 5x squared plus 2 cubed. Let's start with a quick review on how to perform log differentiation. Step 1, we'll take the natural log of both sides of the equation. Step 2, we'll apply the properties of logarithms to expand the logs as much as possible. Step 3, we'll differentiate both sides of the equation. Step 4, we'll solve for dy dx. And then step 5, we'll use the original function to substitute for y into our derivative function. Before we start, we should note that we don't have to use log differentiation to find this derivative. We could apply the product rule combined with the chain rule in order to find our derivative function. But for this example, we will use log differentiation. Let's first replace f of x with y. So we would have y equals the quantity 2x minus 3 squared times the quantity 5x squared plus 2 cubed. And now we'll take the natural log of both sides of the equation. And now we'll start to expand the right side of this equation using our property of logarithms given here below. So because we have a product here, we can break this up into a sum of two logs. We would have natural log y equals natural log of the quantity 2x minus 3 squared plus natural log of the quantity 5x squared plus 2 cubed. And now we can apply the power property of logarithms, which means we can take this exponent here and move it to the front so it's the coefficient. And we can do the same with this 3 here. So now we have natural log y equals 2 times natural log of the quantity 2x minus 3 plus 3 times natural log of the quantity 5x squared plus 2. Now that we've expanded this as much as possible, we're now going to differentiate both sides of the equation with respect to x. Now we'll differentiate both sides of the equation with respect to x. And to do this, we'll be using the derivative formula given here. The derivative of natural log u with respect to x is equal to 1 over u times u prime. Again, notice how this is the chain rule, where this first factor is the derivative of the outer function, and the second factor, u prime, is the derivative of the inner function. But also, taking a look at this first derivative here, since our function is in terms of y, this is implicit differentiation, so we'll have an extra factor of dy dx, which is actually just the chain rule. So the derivative of natural log y with respect to x would be 1 over y times dy dx. Again, this requires implicit differentiation because our function is in terms of y, and we're differentiating with respect to x. And now on the right side, we'll have 2 times the derivative of natural log 2x minus 3, so our inner function u is equal to 2x minus 3. So again, the derivative would be 1 over u times u prime, or 1 over the quantity 2x minus 3 times the derivative of 2x minus 3 with respect to x, which would be 2, plus 3 times the derivative of natural log of the quantity 5x squared plus 2. Again, we have to apply the chain rule, where the inner function, or u, is equal to 5x squared plus 2. So our derivative is equal to 1 over u times u prime, or 1 over the quantity 5x squared plus 2 times the derivative of 5x squared plus 2 with respect to x, which would be 10x. Now that we've differentiated, we have to simplify and then solve for dy dx. So on the left side, we would have 1 over y times dy dx. On the right side, we have 4 divided by the quantity 2x minus 3. Plus, this would be 30x divided by the quantity 5x squared plus 2. And now to solve this for dy dx, we'll multiply both sides of the equation by y. So we'd have dy dx is equal to y times our two fractions, 4 divided by the quantity 2x minus 3 plus 30x divided by the quantity 5x squared plus 2. Even though we have this solve for dy dx, we don't want to leave it in this form because we don't want to leave this y in our derivative function. We can replace y with the original function, which is the quantity 2x minus 3 squared times the quantity 5x squared plus 2 cubed. So let's go ahead and perform that substitution on the next slide. So again, what we've done here is we've substituted the original function for this y here. And now we'll go ahead and find this product. When multiplying by this first fraction, notice how one factor of 2x minus 3 is going to simplify out. So this first product would be 4 times one factor of 2x minus 3 times three factors of 5x squared plus 2. And then when multiplying by the second fraction, notice how one factor of 5x squared plus 2 would simplify out. So that would leave us with 30x, and then two factors of the quantity 2x minus 3, and two factors of the quantity 5x squared plus 2. Now we're going to go ahead and factor this by factoring out the greatest common factor of these two products. So the greatest common factor would be 2, and then one factor of 2x minus 3, and two factors of 5x squared plus 2. If we factor this out of the first product, it would leave us with a factor of 2 and then one factor of 5x squared plus 2. If we factor this out of the second product, notice how it would leave us with a factor of 15x and one factor of the quantity 2x minus 3. So you can see a lot of this problem is just algebra. Now we're going to simplify this inside the brackets. So we'll distribute the 2 here and distribute the 15x here. So we'll have dy dx equals 2 times the quantity 2x minus 3 times the quantity 5x squared plus 2 squared. Then we'll have 10x to the second plus 4 and then plus 30x to the second and then minus 45x. And now we'll go ahead and combine the like terms here. So we finally have dy dx equals 2 times the quantity 2x minus 3 times the quantity 5x squared plus 2 squared. And then here we have 10x squared plus 30x squared, that's 40x squared, minus 45x plus 4. So this would be our derivative function using logarithmic differentiation. I hope you found this explanation helpful.